Now the next step is to color, and there are two flowers, so we need to make a distinction between the two subtly. One could be in peach, one in pink. That's the original master painting that did. But we can do that with one more whitish, one with pink. So I'm going to do this slightly different. And you know, one more reddish, more whitish, maybe. So we use two small brush. You can use two combination brushes. Any small brush. We call this separate wash, but you can use you don't have to hold them in one hand. Classically, we do this, like this. You know. So I'll use one brush with a little dilute water and a pink. A little bit white, maybe. The white should be on the tip. So, let's do this way to be easier. I think you could do alternatively one flat wash, one gradation, or one gradation, then flat wash. So it's just like back and forth. I'll show you how I do it. Okay, so let's say if you do the white wash first, you do a flat wash, and then you kind of introduce some deep color in the shady area, for example. So I just do an overall white wash on this front. I always change mine. I was thinking about this to be more reddish, but I decided to do more white in the front, and then the dark one would be on the back. You try not to cover, but that's difficult, I know. So you need to avoid. You can use blot paper if that happens. So basically, you can use another brush, which is damp but not too wet. That will help spread and absorb like sponge off the extra moisture. So see, so you clean up. Because it's not color, so I'm not really doing gradation. I just do a overall flat wash to be a foundation. By the way, if you're using the unsized shrine, this layer will help to build a sized effect in this area. So it's not going to bleed when you wash the colors. You know that what I mean? But with sized paper like this, the cigar strand, that is not necessary to do this white first. You can do the color first, you know, like a rouge or pink or
What happens if you go over the black line?
Just wipe it off with a damp brush. You will bring it back, reinstate it later. It will be covered partially. Somehow, but that makes it more interesting. You know? So try to avoid, but if that happens, just let it be. So that's why it's not pure white, it's diluted, right? It's semi-transparent, semi-opaque. We'll make the tip more solid white, but this point is a kind of medium white. It's got medium white. can do this pretty fast. You know, you can wash several petals in one stroke, and that's possible. Because
then you can go over the black.
Yeah, so it's a flat wash. We call it the overall wash. So it's not concerned with the gradation.
No.
We'll do the gradation next. We could do that first. On the leaves, I will do that for you. But this time, don't worry about that. Oh, sorry. I have to keep this clean brush clean. So you have to clean this. And the one color brush, you use the color as a charger or deliverer. And the one brush as a spreader, or what they call this, sponge brush. It takes away the extra moisture. When you do the gradation, you actually start with dark and then just make it light. But in this case, I try to just make it flat. But still, you can have some more white towards the tip. That's good. We call this separate wash with gradation. One brush with clean water, one brush with the color. But it's hard sometimes, you know, to make a distinction on our techniques. It's all combined. The point is, before you do the next layer, you have to wait the first layer to dry, to set. That's why sometimes, if you want to avoid stir up the first of the previous layers, you need to size them or to set them with a fixture, oven. So I have oven water here.
Uh-huh.
Between layers, but if it's thin, you know, if it's layers, a thin layer, it's not going to create major problems. You can keep doing until you feel there's no more space for extra, you know, more color. Then you use alum to create the surface, redo the surface, refresh the surface.
Mm-hmm.
That's what alum could be. So I just, you know, kind of do overall wash on the front flower. Now I'm going to do the separate wash for the second one with the pink. This time I will do it differently so you can see how that works. So I will use a little rouge and a little pink mix maybe. You can mix any color, just make it a little muted, you know, dark. So this is my charger. And again, I have this soft brush. So this is how I do it. I start from the center. Okay, make that a little. Missed a few lines. I have to wait that to dry. From the bottom of the petal, I start to charge. And there's a center vein like that. It's darker. So I'm on that vein. And then I use the clean brush to spread out towards the top, just like that, see? So the light actually comes from the water, a damp moisture in the pouring brush. The pores drag the... So in the end of this, it should be no extra moisture, unlike the other technique. You might heard of is Talashikomi, the dripping technique, wet into wet. You know, the the
color
kind of flow
bleeds into it.
Yeah, bleeds into it. In this case, there's not much extra moisture. It should be very dry. You pick up the extra moisture with this sponge brush, and you should keep that sponge brush clean and thirsty, you know. Okay. Let me do another one. This basically just filling this little area, and to continue on top, there's a center vein that went around this. So the center is dark and become light.
So you've got one brush lighted up just with water.
Yeah, and it's damp, but not dripping definitely. You see, this is like a sponge. You can use that to drag it, to pull it, to push it away. See, that's how it works. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it's on the camera, but can you see that? You can come sit on this tape, on this chair. You can sit here to see. This is my charger. And here's the process. Okay, I use deep red. And, this brush should have more than adequate, you know, to drip, to create. Oops, sorry, you can see that happens to this. So you should stay away from this leaf. So I deliver a little bit, right? And then kind of push it towards the top. In the end, it should take away the extra moisture. So there's no, just use leftover hands to finish it. So that created, it's not possible to do it in one layer. So it required many.
And then to do the bud up here.
Yeah, you can do.
Forgot all about it.
But you cannot repeat this while it's still wet. So you have to wait it to dry, and then you can repeat this until it reaches the.
Did you do your bud up there?
Do this one? Okay.
No, did you put the white on it? I forgot to do it.
The white? No. This one is deep, so this one I'll do this way, the one I'm working on. The butt is like this, the same like the red one. So it will be drooched, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then clean water brush to pour it. And
well, I'll start with the pink now, Henry.
Yeah, you starting from the pink and the clean water, so no white. We'll do the white later. This is a different approach. The white flower, I did do it to the white first, and then I'll use the.
Well, we're only doing where this pink, aren't we? And the veins.
I haven't done the pink yet. I mean, the white will be added later. So I do the gradation first, and then I will.
This pink here, you're doing.
Oh, do you?
Yes.
The light pink without the white first.
Yep.
So, but if you. Don't get enough, just wait, dry it, and repeat that. So I just do the shady part. The shady part with the pink. This pink flower, we do this separately. So you can start from the end, from the bottom, in both directions, and the meat in between, to create a subtle relation. And take out the extra moisture. There's no extra moisture when you finish on the surface. So this one is the leaf, so just make sure you understand that. And the inside, there's no pink, there's more white, so just avoid that. You can kind of overlap, highlight the outline with pink. That's how much I use. So the back side of the pink flower is more red than the front side.
Mm.
Okay. And,
do you think we need a slightly different shade of red? It's looking very, very bright.
Yeah, I mixed the little rouge with the rose.
Uh-huh.
That's what I did. You can use one color, then the next color combine, you know, in the next layer. You don't have to mix them right now. At this point, I just concerned with the gradation first. Then you can change the color on the last layer. So the back is a little deeper than the center. This one's too dark. You can blot it if you overdo it. I think I messed up with the clean brush and the color brush. That's a common mistake. So just clean the water brush again, just to make sure it's clean. You do the job with that. So if you do it too slow, it might dry up. So you need to do one head at a time.
Yep.
No hurry. This brush is too soft and it's a different one.
Uh-oh.
Something wrong?
I've smudged it. It's going down onto the leaf anyway, so.
So you can cover that with
this
color.
Yes, we can there.
Yeah. So you need to use the blot paper or something to blot it. Reduce the color, then you can cover it. Yeah. So this has to be repeated many times.
To build up the color.
To build up the intensity. And you can also change the hue of each layer. I will go back to the white one while I wait for the pink one to dry. You see there's some here. Before I do that. Okay, now I'll use one clean brush and one brush loaded with some yellow, gray, yellow, and amber.
How's that coming on?
Very good. Mm-hmm. I'm going to try to make it smooth. Yeah. Make it very smooth. And some yellow, green, to mute it, you can add some orange to it. I think that's it. So this is the color. I do the white flower, which is different from...
You've got a lot more color on there than I have.
You can add...
I don't know what this bit is here. Oh, this is going to be very dark here.
Okay. So I try to create the gradation, a depth on the white flower. This is what I'm doing now. Add some more kind of brown color to it in the center. Green, brown.
Mm-hmm.
So we might see some.
You're not doing the lower colors yet.
Yeah, I try to build some. Some color to shade to the white one. The white looks a little more greenish, I think. So we can add some green to it. Just very pale. Actually, this clean brush could also serve as a second color, so it's combination wash,
mm-hmm.
Yeah, the transitional wash. So one is the very light, pale color, one is a little darker. That's what I'm trying to do. So you can highlight this area, and I use more light green. Light green to do pouring. You can have some white show through. You don't need to add any white. It's kind of hard to keep it clean on the white flower. So
I know.
So they just keep it light. That's the point. Keep it light. So they use three brushes, one is totally clean. Got some pink in it. That's okay. Like a reflection of the neighboring flower.
Right. Now, while I've got this pink loaded up, I think I'll come down to the next.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Are we adding another colour to this?
I'm doing right now, you can see. I try to create depths by adding some brown green color in the center.
Right, that
so
sounds
create,
good.
Create
where did you get that from?
I just mixed the green, yellow green. Yeah, yellow green. It was a little brown, whatever. You can use just the. Oh, this is too much red in it. Clean the red brush. I try not to use any red, but I did a little.
But I'm doing this, all this here, there's a lot of red in that.
I don't like that. I try to keep it pure, white.
Oh, more white?
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. And the green. So that's what I...
Oh, white and the green, right.
Yeah. How do you like that so far? Just the pure green?
Yes.
Now we can have a little bit...
I think you'll need to introduce a bit of the pink in it
somewhere, otherwise
it just looks like two different colour flowers.
I see what you mean.
But then hang on, we've got the leaves, so we don't want an argument between the green and the green leaves and the green.
Yeah, so it's a very subtle situation here. Yeah, we can highlight it with green leaves. So we just this grey green to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
But I purposely leave some white out on the highlight part. So the shady part I use the green and the brown color. So basically, I'm doing a green-white flower.
Okay. How's that to be coming on?
Very good, very good. Yeah, I like the one you leave the tip white. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I would have to add the man back because I covered too much, maybe. Yeah, you just do the shady part with green, which is perfect. I should have done that too. To let it dry before we can have more colors. Okay, I will work on the leaves now.
Mm-hmm.
I'll start with the indigo wash. So again, I use clean brush and a color brush. The color brush this time is indigo. You can add a little ink to it if you want. Just make it blue gray. And use clean brush. Okay. Now I start from here. And then to use the clean brush to create a gradation kind of.
Mm-hmm.
You can use very light, instead of pure water, you can use very light indigo versus the dark indigo brush to create this gradation brush. Just one single color. You can do this on all leaves. But there's distinction between the front and the back, right? So on the back of the leaf,
mm-hmm.
I will use a warm color. Is it more red in it? Let me identify those first. You won't miss them. So I got some orange color or brown color to do this part. This part, only two spots I noticed have this. Just use kind of brown green to identify this. You can, brown yellow green mix. And then the other parts should be cold. Okay. Basically, just do an overall wash on each leaf with indigo. Some gradation is preferred. Instead of talashikomi, which is dripping, you know, like flowing,
mm-hmm.
I use gradation technique this time. Underneath, maybe deeper, so I use a darker color.
Now, what color are we dealing with?
Indigo. I use chips here, right?
Uh-huh. So I'm cleaning all this off?
Yeah.
Oh,
I use a different brush.
Yep.
Save that for later. You need the flower brush to continue to build more layers, the depths. So I just use different set of brush. That's why more brushes. Convenient.
Hmm. Now, do you think I've got enough green on there, Henry?
Yes, I think so. You can add more if it dries and feel not enough.
Yes.
Just leave it now because
I'll
you cannot
leave
keep doing it. You
no.
have to wait it dry.
Now, what do we? Oh, that's a fabulous color.
Yeah, it's an indigo in this indigo chip. Yeah, that's the color I used on the hibiscus flower. You liked.
Oh yes,
yeah.
Beautiful.
It's a traditional color. So I try to build a contrast. So I use indigo with a little bit of ink. Just blue, gray. See, if I keep doing wet, too wet, it's going to be fuzzy. I cannot do that. I have to wait it dry. And, okay, so just keep doing this. More indigo. A little ink. Use a little light indigo or clean water if you like, just to spread it out. Okay, here's another curved part I want to use warm color. Avoid covering the petals very carefully.
Yes.
to not use too much water. So the sponge brush is very useful to take it off. Make it even. But on leaves, it's not like flowers. You can have some stains, like, you know, just make it spontaneous. We don't leave the water line, what they call this, the vein line, or the water line, as in some other gombi, because the shape of the leaf is like a mirror. I think it's more like a reflective mirror. Heart shape symbolizes the empty heart. We can have a little color change here.
Okay. It's working out all right.
And for the small leaves, I use more yellow and brown color to begin with. Just like the back of the leaves, just make it simple. So without creating too much variations, I just use this. This is a brown green mix, very light. When the dirty color gets, you know, diluted, it's a nice color. Okay, and this group is the same, but I'll just use some more indigo. Lighter, more greenish.
Now, where's that brownie color? Okay.
Brown color is yellow, indigo, and the brown.
Have you got indigo up there?
Yeah, it's indigo and the yellow and brown. It's a neutral color. Neutral color. Some indigo, of course. I want to keep consistent with the other part. So normally, if it's, you know, more in the back, you want to push it back, use more indigo. That's what I do. This one should be the front, so we'll just add a little yellow to it. Okay.
Oh, let's step back from this.
Okay. Yeah, it's kind of fuzzy. You know, I work too much, very dry before you cut it. And on the butt, I will use a little warm green. Yellow, green. Okay, now I will add some white in my case, because I lost some white.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm going to reintroduce that as white. And with a clean brush to pour it. So this. This pure white. On the tip, I put some of the feathers. And then spread it. Bring the top of the tip. Center should be a little bit more white.
Oh, I've got all these leaves to do yet.
Yeah, there's 7 layers normally. You can do 7 washes. 5 at least. So this is it. Just do it very fine, thin, you know, build it up. Gradually build it up.
Oh, this is such fun, Henry. I'm more confident with this because this is a similar thing to what I do with the icons, you know. It's a bit...
What is that called? Icon...
Iconography, yes.
Iconography, yeah. With canvas, acrylic, right? You do.
No, with tempura.
Tempura. Oh, tempura is also water-based, yeah.
Yep, water-based.
It's opaque.
Depends on what
just like
pigments
doing.
We use. Yeah. Pigments come from Europe.
I see.
They're whole earth pigments, some of them are.
I missed all this leaves here, so I had to look it up.
I know, I'm too.
Back to the leaves.
Has Alan finished for the day?
Yeah.
Oh, no. For these turned over bits of leaf.
The brown colour would be added later, so I...
You know what I'm talking about? With the, here?
Yeah.
And here.
Oh, that's what I identified first. You see what
yes.
I did? Yeah.
Oh. There are more leaves out here.
Mm. And then there's layers of leaves on this side.
Okay.
Hello? Here.